Alcohol inks continue to be enormously popular with artists, crafters, and creatives of all types. In today's video, I'm going in circles making round shapes with Marabu's alcohol ink, which is on sale at 50% off, Tim Holtz's alcohol ink, which is on sale at 25% off, and my surfaces are Graphics Opaque White Plastic and Yupo, both of which are on sale effective today. I enjoy creating round shapes pretty much irrespective of the media or surface. Curvy lines have a real strong appeal for me, and with that in mind, I decided that today I was going to just play with alcohol ink making round shapes, round blobs, round circles, round drops of color. Now, it's pretty darn easy to do. It's as simple as allowing a drop of the liquid to fall from the bottle onto your surface. But you can make that more interesting by working on, like I did here, a surface that's already got color on it, or you can allow the drops to build one on top of another. You can nest them one color inside of another. So if allowing a drip of the color to fall from the bottle is pretty much the easiest way you can do it. Another option for making round shapes are styluses, like these two. This is from Wendy Vecchi's Make Art Perfect Stylus Tool Set, something like that. I forget exactly what it's called. But you get two dual-ended styluses in there for a total of four different sized balls on the end of them. So you can use them to make plain old dots. You can use them to layer dots on a surface. You can use alcohol ink to put down a colored dot, or you can use blending solution or plain old alcohol for something that has no color. So let's start with the easiest thing to do. So today I'm working on Yupo. I have these little pads here. We of course have all the other size pads, and I'm also going to work on graphics opaque white plastic. So I have some smaller pieces pre-cut, and I'm going to start with the simplest thing that you can do, which is to just allow a drop to fall on your surface. Working with Marabu alcohol ink, and I'm working with Tim Holtz's alcohol ink. So the larger piece is Yupo, the smaller piece here is opaque white plastic. And here we go for as easy as it could possibly get. I'm simply going to take a color and I'm going to drop it on the surface. Now, drops behave differently to some degree on Yupo versus opaque white plastic. Yupo is really sensitive to the oils from your skins, so sometimes you don't always get perfect round blooms. Sometimes you do, sometimes the moon is in Aquarius, and sometimes it's not. But you can see that you get pretty easy production of dots by simply doing that. Now, you can get it to become a little bit more interesting. For example, so this is Marabu, this is Magenta. This was Tim's color named Laguna. So I can come in here, snap the cover off, and again, drops, super simple to do. But we can nest them if we want, or we can overlap them. So now you have the creepage thing that goes on. As that color blooms, it will affect what is either around it or near it, depending on how big that bloom gets. So let's do something a little bit different now, and let's go ahead and put some color down and create a background and then see what happens when we put drops on it. So I'm going to bring in a sheet of palette paper because this technique that I use has a tendency to push the ink out, and I don't want to, it will stain the nonstick craft sheet. As this starts to get beat up and the fibers get exposed, it will stain with the alcohol ink, so I'm not going to allow that to happen. I'll just work on a palette pad. So the colors I'm going to work with are Rosewood from Tim's line. I have Metallic Pink, which is one of the new colors that Marabu released in June. And then I have Glitter Pink Green Gold, again, another one of the new colors from June. So pretty straightforward. I just go, you know, while I'm doing this, let me shake both of these. You can hear the mixing balls, and so you have to get that stuff up off the bottom of the bottle and moving. So the metallics take just a tick longer than the glitters do, but that looks like it's up and moving. So this is one of my favorite tools to work with. It's just a coffee stirrer. It couldn't possibly be any less exciting, but it works. So I'm going to put some of the metallic pink down, and then I'm going to put some of the rosewood along the bottom. And I think I'm going to put just a little bit more of the metallic pink. All right, so now all I'm going to do is manipulate these with the coffee stirrer and move them around. Now with the metallic, I'm obviously getting the metallic effect, and that will blend in with the rosewood and create some different looks. Now, as I start to work on this while the colors are wet, you'll see that they'll continue to bloom and I will lose part of that pattern. But if I blow on it and I hasten the drying, then the pattern will stay a little bit more. And so you can see now why I wanted to work on the palette pad, because it really contains, well, there was some blue on there, wasn't there? It really contains those colors and stops them from getting where I don't want them to be. So this is close enough, it's dry enough. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in, again, this is glitter, pink, green, gold. There is stuff on the bottom of the bottle that I'm going to allow to shake, and then I'm just going to go ahead and drop some stuff on here, drop some drops on here. So there's a mixing bowl in here that you heard. If you turn the bottle like this, I can pretty much promise that that mixing bowl is going to fall into the cap and obstruct the ink from flowing. So I find if I hold the bottle more horizontally, there's less of that that happens. I'm being excruciatingly careful here because I don't want to make a mess, but the other thing that I will do sometimes is simply go ahead and touch, which I find actually allows me more control. So this particular color of the glitter, and let's go for a bigger dot there. Okay, so now the mixing bowl was in the way. And I will tell you that Marabu is looking at changing that around. It's not going to happen right away, but they are looking at doing that. So I like to do this because I find that that mixing bowl actually affords me a little bit more control to do really tiny things like this. So this is pretty much bloomed enough. If I hold this up, you can see all that glitter sparkling. It does that kind of sparkle thing in the middle that's just so attractive. It kind of glistens as it moves. So if I hold that so that the glare's not in your way, you can see how this works. Now if I wanted to come back and I wanted to add some more of the metallic pink, I could do that. I can make drops with that. I could come back and I could make drops with the rosewood. I could put a little bit inside some of these bigger circles and allow it to bloom. Now I can do the same thing with the Ranger in terms of holding the bottles more horizontally. It does afford you a little bit more control. It's one of those things where as you play with it, you'll get a sense of what works for you and what doesn't. I mean, the tips are pretty consistent in terms of the size of the opening. So usually if you can find a way to control it, you'll find that it works for most things. So I think that that needs another drop in the center to kind of push that rosewood out. And again, if you experiment, you nest and you layer, you'll find all of these amazing things that happens. So something else that you can do to create really simple dots, again, another piece of opaque white plastic. I'm just going to grab a bottle. Let's come back to this is Laguna. One of the things that you can do is that. I mean, all I'm doing is treating the bottle like a salt shaker. Now, it's far less controlled, but sometimes there's serendipity in that less controlled kind of thing that happens. So if I come in with some lettuce, which I think is a nice pairing with these colors, I can do the same kind of thing. And if I want to make this really interesting, I can come back with this is, well, you know what, let's grab the Marabu. This is magenta. So now I'm going to come in, and you can see that aside from where the colors have run together, everything is pretty much round or circular shaped. And again, I'm doing that same salt shaker technique. I've got my layering going on. This looks pretty cool, and you can see how effortless this is. So now I'll come back in with some of the glitter. I can never remember the name of this, the glitter pink, green, gold, and create even more dots. So up next, I'm going to get some fresh surfaces to work on, and then I'm going to bring in the two styluses and show you how you can use them to create dots of a different sort. As I mentioned a moment ago, with these styluses, you get four different size balls. The tiniest one is 1 millimeter, which is this one, then it's 1.5, 2.5, and 3, and I find that these make such minuscule dots that half the time I don't even bother, so I generally use the 2.5 or the 3, and I'm going to, just to make it easy, I'm going to use the 3. So this is a background that I just did. It's got Marabu's metallic blue, it has eggplant and aqua from Tim's line, and in order to keep this easy to do, I have this little palette cup. So I've got some alcohol back here, which you can't see yet, but I'm going to put some of the aqua in one of the wells, and I will use that to put some color down. You can do this, of course, with alcohol, or you can do it with blending solution. So I find that as much as I want to hold this like a pencil, I find that I get better results if I hold it straight up and down and I place the drops that way. So depending on what's already here is going to influence the shape of your dots or how badly you actually put it down like I just did. But if you want to make a curvy line of dots that get gradually smaller, you can certainly do that by not re-inking, if you will, the ball. So let's just try the 2.5 size, and let's come down over here. Now, this is not great art. That's not what this is supposed to be. This is just my attempt to show you how you can work with this. Now, what size dot you get is also a function of how much of the color you actually kind of scoop onto that ball. So you can see that with that 2.5, it really is very tiny. I could do the same thing with the metallic. I could certainly put some out here. Just going to put a little teeny bit there, and I'm going to grab it with the larger, with the 3mm. But again, you can see that it works. And if you want to do that graduated thing, it's just a question of not reloading in between. So now let's just switch over. I'll turn this around, because I've got alcohol here. So again, same thing. But because alcohol is so thin-bodied, and because it blooms differently than alcohol ink does, I'm going to get much larger circles. So now if I switch over to the 2.5, you can see that my dots are going to be even smaller. I can still do the graduated thing if I want, so I could go and then not reload and get those smaller dots, and you see that they appear as the alcohol does its thing. If I want to bring in the really teeny one, so this is the 1mm end, it's going to make just such a tiny little dot that you practically can't see it. I can see it. It's right there. I think you can just see it on the camera. So this is it. I mean, this is how simple it gets to go with circles and dots and alcohol inks. With a variety of inks and a couple of tools, you can create all kinds of fun.